Caltech's field, Cronulla stunned Canberra with a 24-16 victory. Paul Green's work at halfback and Richard Barnett's pace put the Green Machine out of business. The young Sharks treated their big-name opponents with contempt. It
lead, but the Sharks produced plenty of fight to bridge the gap, and then Mitch Healy put them in front. With a minute to go, the scores were locked at 14-all before Healy booted home the winner. Cronulla undefeated after two rounds.
At Caltech's field, a great start for Cronulla against Illawarra. It was hardly the platform for victory. West went missing as the Sharks cut loose. A six-try second-half romp, including two in 2 minutes. Andrew Ettinghausen landed two late in the game. Cronulla home, 36 points to 10. The Sharks are the Saturday night specialists, and with 25 minutes to go, Andrew Ettinghausen began a personal repair job. ET crossed twice in a four-try final burst to set up the Cronulla victory, the ground record of more than 20,000 delighted, well, most of them anyway. The home side stalled at that point. The defence went missing as Cronulla scored two tries. The second came from Adam Maher, the Sharks going to a 14-10 lead. The demands of rep football sideline David Fairley and DT. Gavin Jones joined them a minute into the game. While he slept it off, the Sharks were wide-eyed. Bennett's kick fingertipped by Hick for a try. Full by-the-book play soon had the Sharks back in front, 16-14. Mistakes didn't help Norse, nor the dismissal of Matt Toshack for a high tackle. With 10 minutes to go, the sealer for Cronulla, half Paul Green finding Neon Crossan right in the corner. A late field goal put the icing on the Cronulla victory. Peter Overton, National 9 News.
If Balmain had any thoughts of an upset, dynamic halfback Paul Green buried them at Caltech's field just 8 minutes in. It was a big night for Ettinghausen, first throwing the final pass for Crossan's swan dive in the corner, then crossing for his own landmark try with a classic swerve and step around the fullback. Balmain's John Elias was put on report for his hit on Andrew Pearce.
Cronulla management went to extraordinary lengths to welcome new Kiwi recruit Dave Watson, and his gratitude was overwhelming as he set up try after try in a record spree at Caltech's field.
Green gets the bat away.
His passing was outstanding. Paul Bell can thank him for three tries.
Bell gets the try.
The Gold Coast defence had no answers to Watson. Not even three tacklers was enough.
For the fence off, looks to unload, does miraculously, and Neve goes over to score for Dave Watson. Tremendous stuff.
The new fullback was simply unstoppable, Cronulla scoring their highest score ever.
Then back, and the Bell goes in to get another try.
Watson received a standing ovation when he left the field late in the game with an ankle injury. Dale Shearer showing the frustrations of a side beaten almost single-handedly by a Kiwi dynamo.
In future at East is reportedly shaky. Now it might have the death wobble after Andrew Ettinghausen's spectacular overhead pass set Cronulla on the road to victory last night. ET scored two tries of his own, both full of pace and class. His one-man mission directing Cronulla to a 4-2, 20 points to 8 victory.
At Caltech's field last night, high drama as the Cronulla Sharks tore Penrith apart. It was a committed effort from the home side, completely overwhelmed by an incident involving referee Bill Harrigan and Penrith coach Phil Gould. Harrigan ordered Gould from the sideline for disrupting play. Gould at first didn't budge. He eventually remembered the rule. Earlier, Penrith had been on the end of a heavy penalty count and Cronulla didn't waste the advantage. It was a 32-0 drubbing with the well-documented Harrigan-Gould feud now at boiling point.
Cronulla did manage two touchdowns, but 12 points was hardly face-saving on a day that Canberra not only won the game, but the boxing match as well.
Now he wants Clyde to give him a few. Whack, 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 push, push.
Storm back. Andrew Ettinghausen was brilliant in gathering metres. From the play to ball, the scores were level, 6-all. Trailing 14-6 and with 10 minutes to go, Cronulla exploded. Paul Green started it, Dave Boughton completed it.
Now it's Doolan for the line, the last pass to
2 points in it. Craig Polamalu objected to being ruled out of bounds. He was sent off for back-chatting as his teammates hung on for victory.
Cronulla loved to engage in tough, tight contests, and the first half suggested that's exactly what was going to happen today. Although the Steelers opened the scoring with a penalty, it was the Sharks who set the pace. Andrew Neave's try was followed by a poor green bomb. In the swirling breeze, Richard Barnett judged it best to give Cronulla a 10-point lead.
He could take. The Sharks closed the gap, trailing 16-10 at half-time. It was Ettinghausen who saved the night. He scored his third try in a late Cronulla blitz, which reaped 16 points in 11 minutes. Cronulla home, 32-28.
No stage did the Sharks stop trying, and when Manly's intensity dropped late in the second half, Cronulla finally got some points. Last night at Caltex Field, it was wet and cold off the paddock, but things were hot on it. Newcastle's Paul Harrigan and Cronulla's Adam Rickson battled all evening, with the young Shark having the final say. Only 2 points separated the sides at the break. Cronulla's Paul Green lucky to see out the match. In all, the Sharks scored 4 tries to 1, Rickson getting the last in the 26-4 win.
Housen started last night's game with a season try tally of 13. He quickly added to that after some good work from his teammates. Paul Green and Mitch Healy laid on ET's second four-pointer. Cronulla led 14-0 at half-time, but any chance of a Rabbitoh comeback was wiped out. Ettinghausen again. Five minutes later and it was try number four. Andrew Neave delivered the pass. The South's defence was trying, but targets could have been better. This high shot on Adam Ritson. And this one, the tackle of the night on referee Tim Mander. ET finished with 5 tries, doing all the work for his last 4-pointer.